Hey, brothers and sisters, this is Brother Patrick here in the Philippines. Hey, I had made the video, Words for Those Who Asked, number 10, I believe it was, and I'm going to redo it, brothers and sisters, and I'll tell you why. Even though I had some good words on there, I had made this video about the blood moons and stuff, and the Lord had just arrested me about that and wanted me to make another one for Israel. You know, which I remade the one I made for the church. That same night I had remade that video. And so I made those two videos, this video and that first video I made for the blood moons for the church at the same time. And both of them, I redid the one for the church, and then I made one for Israel by the blood moons. And then I tried to go ahead and load the one where I gave people words, and the Lord just telling me not to. And to redo it. And I had a couple people message me and said, well, you know, I could tell that you were being distracted. And so I thank the Lord for those two sisters in Christ who messaged me, and which confirming what I'd already had in my heart from the Lord. So I thank the Lord. That's why I took it down. So I'm going to attempt to redo it by God's grace, God's mercy. Brothers and sisters, I play music on the prayer over videos to pray for people. Praise the Lord. I'm very busy with the ministry here. It's really a full-time job, all the ministry here. The orphanage is just one thing. The feeding programs. I deal with lots of pastors, all kinds of topics, planting churches. And I have a Bible school, too. We don't have a class at this time. I haven't gathered another. Well, the Lord hasn't sent the students. We don't have a class at this time. You know, when we get enough students, we have a class. A year, it's a one-year school, we do. And then 1 year practical, they'll go to a church for 1 year also. It's the second year. Anyway, brothers and sisters, I want to try to do this list. I ask you to come in agreement and pray with me. And I don't know if the sister saw it, but I'd given a word for a sister. And then a sister had messaged me that she had got a word for that same sister. I'm trying to, it's a sister we talk about, HB is the sister. And I believe I gave her a word. I think she saw it about having, you know, her husband being her main concern. And then this sister messaged me and said she saw, you know, really like, you know, black birds is what she saw in the yard. And then these white doves came and drove the black birds out of your yard. So I see that as, you know, the Holy Spirit coming and removing any problems, bringing light and love and the presence of the Lord to your home, more increase in your home, Sister HB. So I'm going to start on this list. I ask you guys to pray and agree with me. I got this other stuff I want to talk about. The Lord's been showing me. I just want to tell you guys, I usually don't play music. Like I say, the pray over. I'm trying to do pray over. We are so close to the rapture, brothers and sisters. I'm not going to set a date, but, you know, the video I made about the trident in February 2013, the title of the video was Last Roads, or the Last Sign Before the Rapture. And if you guys have been following my videos, I've been giving all these road signs. I don't know how many I did, 12, maybe 10, I don't know, videos about the road signs where God would show me, maybe more than that, I have no idea. And the trident was the last sign. I mean, Lord has been showing me about the blood moons and all that stuff. And I usually don't get into that. And about the number four. Of course, you got four blood moons, but it's also, you know, the four cardinal points, north, the south, east, and west. Lots of meaning, the four gospels. There's lots and lots of stuff about the number four from the Lord's perspective and from the enemies and the creation and all that. But I just want to tell you guys that tonight, if you don't hear anything else in this video, words of knowledge and all that is awesome. As I said in the video I just posted about divine healings, I had, you know, one video, a feedback of someone whose her brother was healed. That girl is like 15 now. This is her older brother at that time. That was in 2006. In July 2006, her brother was healed by the Lord when I prayed for him at an evangelistic crusade in their town called the Fishing Village. It's still healed today. But like I said, all the signs and wonders is really just the purpose is to get people saved. But in the end, that's what it's all about. Where will you spend eternity? In heaven or hell? Let's start with this list. I ask you guys to pray in agreement. Beyond time and space is our Lord. Let's pray again. Let's start with the very first name I had last time, Kathleen C. Now, Father, right now, in the name of Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God, we give you the praise. We pray for Sister Kathleen C. in Jesus' name. And I hear the Bible verse. I do not remember what I said on the last video. I can go back and review it. With the words I get from the Lord, it goes right through my spirit, out of my mouth. And 99% of the time, I couldn't tell you any idea what I said. Unless the Lord calls it back to my memory for some purpose. If I talked to that person, it came back. Kathleen said, I keep hearing it's not by might nor power, but by my spirit, saith the Lord. I have no idea what I said in the last video. It'll be interesting because I haven't looked at the video. I would like to go back and review it and see, you know, if it matched. Even though the Lord can give someone more than one word, right? I mean, it could give you a word that applies today. Something you looked at or prayed about today, it wouldn't apply to last week. So, Kathleen C., it's not by might nor by power, but by my spirit, saith the Lord. That's when he's talking about rebuilding the temple with Zerubbabel. And it's in the book of Zechariah. I think it's 4:16. I could be wrong about that. I think it's like Zechariah chapter 4. You can Google it. Download the e-sword and search it. It's in Zechariah. See, Arnold from Arizona. Let's pray right now. Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, we come in agreement to pray for Brother Arnold of Arizona right now, Lord. Father, we give you the praise and the glory. Hallelujah. Father, we thank you. We honor you. We worship you. We praise you, Father, in the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Father, we exalt thy holy name in this place. Hallelujah. Hear the word Jim Beam. The name Jim Beam. Now, Brother Arnold, I just heard, as soon as I started praying for you, I heard the name Jim Beam. Now, we know that's a cheap whiskey, cheaper whiskey than Jack Daniels and all that. I don't know what that means, Brother Arnold. I don't remember the word I gave in the last video for you. I don't know if you got a chance to see it, but I just heard Jim Beam. And so let's pray for Brother Arnold. Maybe Brother Arnold's a former drinker, or he's been drinking some now, or I don't know what. We pray for you, Brother Arnold, in Jesus' name. Hallelujah, Lord. We pray for the victory for Brother Arnold right now. We give you the praise. Let's pray for Brother Earl D. Hallelujah, Father. We give you the praise and the glory. Hallelujah, Lord Jesus. It's a constant struggle is what I hear. A constant struggle. Hallelujah. A war against the flesh. But thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen. For such is the kingdom of heaven. Hallelujah. The Lord. By his grace. Lord, we pray for Brother Earl D. to have his victory, Lord, through the blood of Jesus over the world, the flesh, and the devil. Hallelujah. As even as the Apostle Paul says, we war against our flesh. Not when he's talking about we battle not against flesh and blood, but against powers and principalities. He's saying that we war against our own flesh. Our spirit man wars with our flesh. Brother Earl, God bless you. Thank the Lord for his grace and mercy on all of us, because we are all lost and without hope in this world without the grace of God. His mercies are new every morning. Praise God for that. We pray and believe and agree with you, Brother Earl D. Lord, you know, as they say, if you starve, you know, if you don't eat, you're going to die. So the advice I can give to anybody that wants to get closer to the Lord, starve the flesh, the things of the flesh, and it will die. And feed the spirit, and it will grow. If you feed something, it grows. If you starve something, it dies. Starve your flesh and feed your spirit. Amen. You know what I mean? Reading the Bible, praying, listening to worship music, watching videos about end times, watching videos, preaching, whatnot, that you like. Feed the spirit. Starve the flesh. You know, if you like to look at, not you, Earl, anybody, I'm talking about generalization here. You like to look at a porno, don't look at it. Turn it off. Turn off your computer. Whatever you got to do to overcome it. Turn off your internet if that's what it takes. You know, something like that. As an example, you like to drink alcohol, don't go to the bar. don't go buy any. Just don't go in the store and buy it. Try, you know, start there. Don't have it in the house and then try not to drink. You know what I mean? Cigarettes. Don't buy any cigarettes. Just like me, I love to eat. If there's chocolate, I keep telling my wife a million times, don't buy junk food. If it's in the house, I'm going to eat some of it. If it's not here, I can, you know, I can overcome it. But if it's here and I see it, I want to eat some chocolates and chips or whatever it is. If I can see it, I want to get a hold of it. You know what I mean? So just don't tempt me with it, and I can overcome it. You know what I mean? It's like that. If you're a former alcoholic, you don't go hang out in bars. Go hang out as a man and try to evangelize prostitutes. You know, you let women do that, or go with a group of Christian women, and if that's what the Lord leads you to do. Let's see. Holly B. Father, right now in the name of Jesus, we come in agreement. We pray for Sister Holly B. And Lord, we just honor, we praise you, Lord. We magnify your holy name. Hallelujah. I just keep hearing the Lord say what he said a minute ago. You know, thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever and ever. Amen. Hallelujah. For Jesus was talking about the Father. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever and ever. Amen. That's really a word for everybody, I guess. The kingdom and the power and the glory belong to God alone. God Most High, creator of heaven and earth. Hallelujah. We thank you, Lord. He's the only one that can give somebody a word when he wills, when he chooses through somebody, or directly through an angel, through a dream, through a vision, or out of the mouth of someone he would use and operate in the gift of the word of wisdom, word of knowledge, or whatever it is, prophecy, or a preacher, or someone, anyone who's a Christian, who's witnessing. God can speak through us. Go read in there when it talks about, like in the book of Acts, it says, Peter, being filled with the Holy Spirit, said blah, blah, blah. That's Luke is really good about bringing that up, about the Holy Spirit in the Gospel of Luke and in the book of Acts, which is part two of the treatise written by Luke to his friend in Rome. Let's see, who was probably a Roman senator or official in the Roman government. Probably, they say. Theophilus, whatever his name is. I just pray right now, Lord, we come in agreement for Sister Holly. Hallelujah, hallelujah, Father, in Jesus' name we give you the praise. As I already mentioned at the beginning of this video about HB, that was Holly B. Hallelujah, Father, we give you the praise. And in the last video I said, and the Lord is reminding me of that again, you know, that your worry and your concern is with your husband. Hallelujah. But God, thanks be to God who gives us the victory through Christ Jesus. Hallelujah. That's what the Lord is saying for you, sister, for Brother Earl, is about, you know, overcoming the flesh. And the overcoming of ourselves, our flesh selves, to be victorious by the Spirit in our own spirit, in Christ. You, Sister Holly, what the Lord is saying is, thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory. Is God alone is sovereign over salvation. You know, nobody gets saved unless the Father calls them, Jesus said. The Father is the one who's, by the Spirit of God is the one dealing with people. The Holy Spirit brings conviction. And it's the Holy Spirit that's moving in people's hearts and minds when they hear the word. And of course, it's the Lord Jesus Christ, who is the Savior, the Redeemer. So in other words, God. You talk about God. When you say God, of course, it's all one. You can be talking about God, the Father, God, the Son, Jesus Christ, or the Holy Spirit. Anyway, the salvation and the deliverance and the victory is God's alone. The kingdom is His. For that is the kingdom, the power, and the glory. Sister Holly. Just roll your burdens over there on the Lord. For he is sovereign, hallelujah, over the affairs of men, over the affairs of men. He is the Most High God. He is El Elyon. That's Hebrew for Most High God. El Shaddai, God Almighty, hallelujah, as he revealed himself to Abraham. Jason E., hallelujah, Father, we give you the praise. In the glory right now, we pray for Brother Jason E. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, Father, we give you the praise and the glory, Lord. I speak right now to victory, victory, victory in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Victory, victory, victory in the name of Jesus. Lord, bless and honor and glory and power unto you, Lord God. I don't know what your E stands for. I didn't write it down. If it is, I don't know. I think it is Edwards. I'm saying that because there's something about that name Edwards or your last name that I didn't write down here that has a something to it and a meaning to it. I had to go back and look it up, brother. You know what your last name is? There's a meaning there. Or the name Edwards or Edward. It's a meaning to you, Brother Jason. That's what I keep hearing. In the name of Jesus Christ, the Son of the Living God, I pray for Brother Jason. Lord, we pray for Brother Jason in Jesus' name, Lord. Hallelujah, Lord. To God be the glory for the things he has done. Lord, we give you the praise. We give you the honor. Lord, we give all the credit and glory and honor to you, Lord God, that you are the one, Lord God, who speaks to people, Lord. As I've already mentioned, I'll speak it again. God deserves all the glory, all the credit for all healings, all like in the video I made of the healing, of the testimony about healing, words of wisdom. All these gifts come from above, from the hand of the sovereign God. Hallelujah. We praise you, Father, in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. 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 Father, we give you the praise. Brother Edward, that's what I've got right now. Or Jason. Brother Jason, I'm sorry. That's what I got right now. I need to go back and review the old video. Maybe I can... The parts of it that's flowing as the Lord wills, I can add it on here. Father, right now I pray for Brother Rob D. Father, we give you the praise and the glory. Hallelujah, Lord Jesus. Hallelujah, Father, we give you the praise and glory, Lord, and we thank you, Lord God, for your blessings, Father. Hallelujah, Lord Jesus. Be fruitful and multiply. Be fruitful and multiply, Brother Rob D. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, and replenish the earth in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Sister Brenda, right now we pray for you, Sister Brenda, in the name of Jesus Christ. We come in agreement and pray for Sister Brenda. Hallelujah, hallelujah, Father, we give you the praise. We give you the praise. Hallelujah. And the Lord is saying, come unto me, all ye burdened and heavy laden, and I will give you rest, for my yoke is easy, my burden is light. And that particular part, it's a part the Lord is highlighting to me. My burden is light. Sister Brenda, the Lord is specifically, that's from Matthew chapter 11. Lord is specifically highlighting this specifically, that part of this said, my burden is light. The Lord's burden is light, Sister Brenda. Maybe you're taking it too heavy. You know, you're carrying things too heavily, you know, and you're taking things too heavy. And the Lord's burden is light. You know, we got to cast our cares on him because he cares for us, the Bible says. Sister Nancy, Father, right now in the name of Jesus Christ, the Son of the Living God, Lord, we thank you, Lord. We pray for Sister Nancy. Hallelujah, Father, we give you the praise and the glory, Lord God. Father, we thank you for your blessings, for your grace, for your mercy, for Sister Nancy. Hallelujah, Father, we give you the praise and the glory right now in Jesus' name, Lord. It's not by power, but by faith, Lord God. It's by faith, Lord God. Hallelujah, Sister Nancy. I believe the Lord is telling me that you know, you're having a lack of faith or trouble in the faith department. The Bible says to every man God has dealt the measure of faith. So we all have a measure of faith. There's the gift of faith, which is in 1 Corinthians chapter 12, the gift of faith like to raise the dead. As an example, the gift of faith in operation is having the faith to believe, to pray for someone to be raised from the dead. This is not the normal measure of faith that we've been given, but a supernatural level of faith to believe for someone to be raised from the dead. But to every man who's dealt the measure of faith, Sister Nancy. So God has given you that measure of faith. We ask the Lord to help you in increasing your faith. Someone prayed to the Lord about healing, and he said, Lord, help me with my unbelief. And the Lord did. The Lord had mercy on him and healed his child. And the gospel's there. Aspen S. Father, right now we pray for Aspen S. In the name of Jesus Christ, the Son of the Living God, Father, we declare victory right now for Aspen S. In the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah, Father. Hallelujah. And Lord has given me the word orders, like O-R-D-E-R, you know, orders. I was thinking in my mind, it's like the steps of a righteous man are ordered by the Lord, but the Lord is saying, no, it's the word orders with an S on it. Like military orders, or the Lord is giving you orders, and you know you need to do it. Orders is the word I hear for you. Or maybe you're working a restaurant and you take orders, I don't know. But the word I've got for you, Aspen, S, is one word, orders. There's also different orders, like the order of Demolay, which I want to talk about, Jacques Demolay, in another video. The order of Eastern Stars, example, whatever. There's lots of orders, which is also the order of the Knights Templar, or whatever. You know, it's a fraternity or a group or whatever. Could be that too. But orders is the one I got with the S. And I said all that, but I believe in this case it refers to orders, like military orders. Is what the Lord is talking about. H-A-N-Y. Hanwy. Father, right now in the name of Jesus, we come in agreement and pray for Brother Hanwy. And Father, we just speak, Lord, hallelujah. And what I hear is the word exalt the Lord on high. There's a song. Exalt the Lord our God. Exalt the Lord our God. Exalt the Lord. What I heard not is exalt the Lord our God. Exalt the Lord on high. Exalt the Lord on high. That's what I hear from the Lord for you. Hanwy, exalt the Lord on high. Lift him up. Lift him up. Lift up the Lord's name. Exalt him. Exalt the Lord on high. Hallelujah. Pamela K. Now, Father, right now, in the name of Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God, Lord, hallelujah, we just lift up Pamela K. to you right now in the name of Jesus. And hear the word peace. 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 Peace like a river. Peace and prosperity for you. Not in the way the world talks about peace and prosperity. That's the code words they use to bring in the kingdom of Antichrist. But this case we're talking about from the Lord. Peace and prosperity. Peace I give unto you, not as the world gives, I leave with you, as the Lord said to his disciples. The peace of the Lord be your strength. The peace of the Lord is your strength. Sister Pamela K. The peace of the Lord is your strength. I think the Lord would give me the unction to give you a word, sister. Sometimes words I hear softly, and then sometimes it's strong, and yours is strong. I mean, you can tell if you watch my videos when I'm giving these words. Sometimes, boom. It flows and it's a lot. Sometimes it's just one word. I can't help it. I don't know why the Lord would give some to others. You need it more, obviously, or whatever. I have no idea. You can ask the Lord yourself, or when you get to heaven, we can find out by His grace. We'll have an eternity. Praise God, an eternity to find out. Amanda Crones. Oh, I'm sorry. I did that last time. I repeated her last name. Sorry about that, sister, but... Father, right now we pray for Amanda right now in the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Father, we give you the praise and the glory in the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah, Lord. Hallelujah. Father, we praise you. We honor you. We worship you and we exalt you, Lord. And we thank you, Lord, for Sister Amanda, Lord. We ask for your wisdom and guidance unto her. Father, in the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. I keep hearing the word obnoxious. Obnoxious. Maybe you're dealing with someone, Sister Amanda, who is obnoxious. Or maybe, I don't even want to say, maybe you're evangelizing people too hard as an example. I don't know. Maybe it's for you, you know. Or maybe someone's doing that to you. The Lord has just given me the word obnoxious. That's why I keep praying. Let's continue to pray for Sister Amanda C. right now in the name of Jesus. Father, we give you the praise and glory in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. And the Lord is just telling me, giving me the word exhortive, which is, you know, to exhort someone. That's to encourage people. So I don't know if the Lord is telling me to exhort you or the Lord is saying He wants you to be exhortive. And I believe that's really what it is. You know, I'm always very cautious about giving a word of like correction, especially just from I don't even know somebody and I'm giving a word of knowledge. But I believe that the Lord gave me the word obnoxious and then exhortive. So the Lord is saying, you know, when you're going to give the gospel, do it in an exhortive way. which means to make it positive, make it encouraging and uplifting, not so aggressively. So maybe you are the one doing that, Sister Amanda, or someone is doing it to you, or you're watching or thinking about doing it that way or whatever. It's for everybody. But that's the word the Lord gave me, Sister Amanda, and that's what I put out right now. Praise His name. Hallelujah. Brooke J. Praise God for His blessings. Sister Brooke J., lift up your voice. Lift up your voice. Praise the Lord. Hear the sound. The sound of the nations calling. Who will go for us? Isaiah chapter 6. The Isaiah in the year that King Uzziah died. Isaiah saw the Lord high and lifted up. You know, in the trail of His robe filled the temple with glory. And then the God said, you know, to God the Father said to the Son, who was concealed in the Old Testament. And He said, who will go for us? Hallelujah. Hear the sound of the nations calling. Brooke J., who will go for us? Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I hear joy bells ringing. Joy bells ringing. Holy unto the Lord, Sister Brooke J. Holy unto the Lord are His chosen vessels. As He says in Zechariah, even in the millennial reign of Christ is what He's talking about. Even the normal plates and cups in people's houses will have holy to the Lord written on them. In other words, everything, even not Jews, but Gentiles and everybody and everything during the millennial reign is holy unto the Lord. It doesn't have to be, you know, the gold vessels in the temple and the censer and the tongs and whatever, all the stuff they use for the sacrifices. And it goes on and on and on about there back there when it's laying out about the law and making those instruments to be used in the temple. We Gentiles, who were once far off, are now holy to the Lord by the blood of Yeshua, HaMashiach, Jesus the Messiah, Jesus the Christ. Hallelujah. Don't let no Judaizer, as the Apostle Paul calls them, Judaizers, put you under the law. As it says in Galatians, you've been set free from the law of sin and death. Hallelujah. You've been raised with Christ. Hallelujah. To seat in heavenly places, far above all powers, principalities, and forces of darkness in high places. That's from Ephesians. Hallelujah. Blessed be the God Most High. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Blessed be the God, God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. And blessed be His Son. Hallelujah, the Lord Jesus Christ. Brooke J., I hear joy bells ringing. Victory is thine in Christ Jesus. Hallelujah. I've given you lots of words. I don't know what to tell people. I give somebody a big word, someone just a little bit. I can only say what the Lord would allow me to say. Hallelujah. I'm trying to speak. It's a supernatural gift. There are people say, you know, giving somebody a word of knowledge. It's a supernatural gift, just like interpretation. Or some people say, you said something in Hebrew and I wrote it down. You got a translation of it in the flesh because you looked up the words or whatever. That's not interpretation. That's translation. These are supernatural gifts of the Spirit. It's not something you're looking up in a dictionary, even though that's true. If it's plainly in a language that you can look up or understand, that's one thing. But the supernatural gift of interpretation of some language you do not know. Johnny G. Father, right now we pray for Brother Johnny G. in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. And I say, do not look to the right or to the left. Do not look unto the right or to the left. But follow the straight and narrow way that the Lord has placed before you. For His giftings and callings are without repentance. Hallelujah. Brother Johnny G., His giftings and callings are without repentance. Look not unto the right or unto the left. For every good gift comes down from above, from the hand of the Most High God. Hallelujah. That's why the Lord exhorted us and said, give us this day our daily bread. Because every good gift comes down from the hand of the Lord God, Most High, Creator of heaven and earth, Brother Johnny G. Justin H. Father, right now we pray for Brother Justin H. Right now, in the name of Jesus Christ, and I keep hearing it's a play on your name. The Lord will do that sometimes too. Just in time, Well, you know, Justin H., I guess you made it into the kingdom just in time. Or if you're praying for one of your relatives, they're going to make it into the kingdom just in time. Because he's an on-time God. Oh, yes, he is. He may not get there when you want him, but he'll get there right on time. He's an on-time God. Oh, yes, he is. Just in time for Justin H. or the person you're praying for, your family member, or yourself. Just in time. Daphne S. In Jesus' name, Father, we pray for Sister Daphne S. I hear the word link. There's a link. Daphne S., there is a link. Are you linked to Justin H.? I don't know what that means. The Lord is telling me there's a link. Oh, maybe it's an internet link. Hallelujah. Father, I right now we pray for Sister Daphne S. in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah, Father, we give you the praise. I hear the word link. And the Lord kept repeating the word link to me. And then I see, like on the cover of the book that I wrote, that giant foot. I've got one copy of that book here now. The other copy I let somebody else have here, one of my wife's relatives. I saw like this big foot like here. It's like the Lord's foot. And then I keep hearing the word link. And then I see this foot of the Lord right here. It's what I kept seeing in the vision. So I didn't see the snake under it, but just the giant foot of the Lord. Like, well, the Bible says, you know, the Lord said unto my Lord, sit at my right hand until I make your enemies your footstool. You know, and the earth is the Lord's footstool, you know, when he talks about there, Stephen is quoting from the Old Testament, they're talking about building the temple. You know, who can build a temple for God when the earth is his footstool? That's from Acts chapter 7 and 8. In there, where, 7, where Stephen gives a sermon there to the Sanhedrin. So the earth is the Lord's footstool, and also his enemies will become his footstool in the millennial reign. You know, when the Lord returns, Daphne. Ray K. Father, right now in the name of Jesus Christ, we pray for Ray K. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Father, hallelujah, we give you the praise. We pray for Brother Ray K. right now. And the Lord is telling me, you know, call on the Lord while he's near. Call on the Lord while he may be found. The Lord is near. The Lord is near. So he can hear to those who call upon his name. Hallelujah. The Lord is near. To those who hear. Not him hearing, but to those who hear. The Lord is near to those who hear. Ray K. That's from the Lord. Discipleship. Discipleship. I hear the word discipleship. Brother Ray K., I hear the word discipleship. Hallelujah. The Lord is near for those who can hear. Call on the Lord while he is near. I've got Mark L. Father, right now in the name of Jesus, we pray for Mark L. In the name of Jesus, I speak liberty. Liberty right now from vices in the name of Jesus Christ. For Mark L. Liberty from vices in the name of Jesus. For Mark L. Victory in the name of Jesus Christ over vices. Hallelujah. Mike L. Hallelujah. Father, right now we pray for Mike L. Hallelujah, in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. And I hear this life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness for Mike L. Hallelujah. Life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. Life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. Blessings and honor and thanksgiving to our God. Hallelujah, for he's worthy of all praise. Hallelujah, Mike L. Be loose from the things of this world. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah. I just speak deliverance from Mike L. also. Mark and Mike. Deliverance in Jesus' name. Pauline L. Pauline L. Pray for Pauline. We pray for Pauline L. right now in the name of Jesus. And I declare victory right now for Pauline. Hallelujah. And Pauline, the Lord is telling me your testimony. Give your testimony, Pauline L. Give your testimony, and it will accomplish the Lord's will. It will accomplish what he pleases in Jesus' name. It will not return unto him void. Hallelujah. If you give your testimony, somebody's going to get saved. Hallelujah. Bill, that's Bill I or Bill L again. Maybe it's the same. All these have L, but this is Bill L, I think, or maybe I put a Bill I. Just a I guess it's L because I draw this other line on there. Father, right now we pray for Brother Bill in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Father, we give you the praise. Father, right now we pray for Brother Bill. Hallelujah, Lord. We just pray for the victory right now in Jesus' name. And I hear for you, Brother Bill, that the sky is the limit. The sky is the limit. Father, we just honor you. We praise you right now. Father, we give you the praise and glory in the name of Jesus. All these L's is getting in my mind, maybe, because I hear the word Lipitor. Now, that's like a liver medicine, Lipitor, for, you know, if your LDL is too high. I don't know if that's for you, Brother Bill, or not. Maybe I'm getting crossed my wires here because all these L's are getting in my mind. But I think I hear Lipitor. So maybe you have high cholesterol or what. But we pray for you if you do, to obey what we know about diet and things like that. We pray for you to be healed in Jesus' name if that's true. Or like I said, could be crossed up with all these L's. We've had Mark, Mike, Pauline, and maybe Bill L all in a row. And them L's is getting me, you know. Getting the L is stuck in my mind. Father, we give you the praise and glory in Jesus' name. I pray for Sister Barb. And I don't have a last initial. Sister Barb. As in Barbara, but this is just Barb. She specifically said Barb. So you know who you are, Sister Barb. Father, right now, in the name of Jesus Christ, we pray for Sister Barb. Father, we just thank you for the victory, the grace, the mercy, the light of your love. Hallelujah, Lord God, we praise you. We pray for Sister Barb. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Father, we thank you, Lord Jesus. Hallelujah, Lord. We give you the praise. Glory, glory, glory. Hallelujah. Alamosa my Yahweh. Hallelujah, my Yahweh. I hear this word, you know, just like I heard that Lipitor thing. Now I hear the word antiques. Or an antique. Hallelujah, Father, we give you the praise. We pray for Sister Barb. Lord, we just pray for Sister Barb in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. I'm going to come back to you, Sister Barbara. Barb, excuse me. Sorry, guys. Throat's a little bit dry tonight. Let's go on to... Hannah from California, I think. Pray for Sister Hannah right now in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Father, we give you the praise. Hallelujah. In the name of Jesus. Lord, we just speak your victory right now in Jesus' name. Hallelujah for our Sister Hannah. Hallelujah, Father, we honor you and we praise you, Lord God. Hallelujah, Lord, we thank you for Sister Hannah, Lord. We come in agreement right now, Lord God, for the health of her baby in Jesus' name, Lord God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, Father, we just pray right now for her to have a healthy baby in Jesus' name, Lord God. We speak right now, hallelujah, Lord, that she would have no vices in her life, that her husband would have no vices, anything around her baby in Jesus' name, Lord God. Hallelujah. We just declaim victory right now. We declare victory for her, Lord God. We declare victory, Lord, and for her to have a healthy baby. Lord, we just speak deliverance, Lord, from all vices, anything that would be harmful to her pregnancy, harmful to her baby, Lord God. We declare that it would be removed, Lord God, in Jesus' name, Lord. Hallelujah, Father, we give you the praise. Hallelujah, Father, we give you the praise in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. For Sister Hannah, right now in Jesus' name. Carrie B. Father, we pray for Carrie B. right now in Jesus' name, Lord. Hallelujah. Let your light so shine before men that they may see your good works and glorify your Father, which is in heaven, Carrie B. Right now in Jesus' name. I declare that's the word of the Lord for you, Sister Carrie B. Let your light so shine before men that they would see your good works and glorify your Father, which is in heaven. Kendra G. Father, right now, in the name of Jesus, we pray for Kendra G. We pray right now, Lord God, Hallelujah, Lord. Hallelujah. 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 Father, we give you the praise. Hallelujah, Lord. God, we give you the praise. Lord, we just thank you for Kendra G right now in the name of Jesus. Father, we thank you, Lord God, for your spirit, Lord God. For, Lord, it's all in your power and in your hand, Father. We know that you can do all things, Father. Hallelujah, in Jesus' name, Lord God. I better stop right there, brothers and sisters. I guess I need to go back, and I will cut off the last few minutes of this and go back to where I really stopped there, I guess, with Bill. Let's go back.